Well, traditional leaders are made up of kings and chiefs from the northwest, Limpopo, Gauteng and Mpumalanga are currently meeting in Soshanguve north of Pretoria to formulate a common position around the issue of land expropriation without compensation. Our reporter Ofense Setimo spoke to one of the chiefs about the contents of the meeting.
We're coming to you from the Christian Revival Center in Block BB, Soshanguve, where chieftaincies from different tribes are actually meeting here to forge a way forward on the issue of land. And from what we've heard so far is that they're actually not satisfied in the manner in which the Land Commission has actually handled the land without putting the chiefdoms at the center of what is transpiring. But joining me right now is Mr. Petrus Ndaba, the convener of this gathering, who's going to explain to us, Mr. Ndaba, why is it important for this gathering to actually take place?
The importance of this gathering to take place is to let all South African community that the native tribal movement are here now to rescue a South African from the land that has been forcefully taken with the bloodshed by the British colonial master and monster. So now we want our government authorities, they must understand that we are the rightful kingdom or tribal authorities, that they can come and talk to us about our land. They must not go to the people who are not owning the land. It's fine, they can go to them with another issue, but not about the issue of the land. About the issue of the land, they need to come to us, because taking us pillar to post, we cannot tolerate anymore. What we are going to do, we are going to contest the vote, that we must have a power from a voters, that we must have also a power from the ex, that all South Africans, they will vote with us, because they know there's a truth to us. Because now, for example, they democrate a place like Piet Retief, and Piet Retief is under a KwaZulu kingdom.
Can you just explain to us on the issue of taking land without compensation? As the representative of the different kingdoms, how do you feel about that?
The question is that, what land they are going to take without compensation is fine. But the land that is left is only 13% land. And that 13%, it simply means that all the kingdoms are sharing on that 13% land who are left when the land was swept away by the British colonial 1879, which the last kingdom to be colonized were the kingdom of KwaZulu.
Yeah. That was Mr. Petrus Ndaba, who's the convener of the Native Tribal Indigenous Movement, who was actually explaining that the Land Commission is actually a farce, as it actually speaks to the people who belong to the different chiefdoms, but actually does not consult with the different kings. And from that onwards, it's back to studio.